been out drinking with the gang last night. They ran up against some Templars and killed one. But Nigel was too sozzle to get away. Now the constables have him up for murder.
You got no cause to lock me up!
This is going to go bad for you. Confess, and you'll save us all some grief.
Oh, I didn't do nothing. So help me, Bob! Miss Evie, we kept buying drinks. The next thing I know, they say I burnt someone.
Oh, Nigel.
I had one too many and lost all my things. They must be scattered all about. Oh, and there's a knife out there too. Could you get them before the Rozzers do?
Shut up!
If I'm not mistaken.
You won't keep this up!
I'll be my honor! Careful! Look at what's going on!
What evidence are you holding this man?
Why, on, Sergeant?
I believe at a minimum you need a body.
We can't find a thing, Inspector.
You botched another one, Sergeant.
Yeah!
Another exciting night home for Evie Frye.
Just on my way out, actually. I found the Peace of Eden.
What's this one going to do, hmm? Heal the sick? Deflect bullets? Control the populace?
They're dangerous objects, Jacob, especially in Templar hands.
Oh, you sound exactly like Father.
If only. Lucy Thorne is expecting a shipment tonight. She's Starek's expert in the occult. I'm nearly certain she is receiving the Peace of Eden Sir David Brewster mentioned.
Sounds like fun. Mind if I join you?
Promise you will stick to the mission.
I swear.
The contents of that box are worth more than your life and those of your entire family. Do you understand?
Yes, Miss Thorne.
Careful there! And double the guard on that cart!
Now, Miss Thorne, there's the matter of some papers for Mr. Starek. If you'll just come this way.
Very well, but make it quick.
Whatever it is she's after, it's in that chest.
There are gunmen on the rooftops.
Can you dispose of them before I reach the cart?
I was hoping for a challenge.
There he is!
I think it's best we leave.
What did you do?
It's hardly the time for questions!
Whoa! Come on!
We can't hide.
Then where's your Peace of Eden?
Get us out of this and I might find out!
Come try and knock us off the cart then! My sister can dodge bullets too!
Damn it.
up the train for you. Lack of paint, new rugs from Camden Loch, and my wee sister, the seamstress, right the did a discount on the curtains.
For a bit, not long, few minutes.
Right in the pan.
Take the pet.
You may have not found a piece of Eden, but this material is invaluable. Look. It says the London assassins had found a shroud.
The Shroud of Eden is supposed to heal even the gravest injury. If the assassins had found something like this, surely Father would have known.
There must be something we're missing.
Something only we can see. These look like directions. Are you coming?
Fieldwork is not really my speciality.
We found a clue to a precursor object. Don't you want to follow it?
Put that way, one can hardly refuse.
There you go.
I think this map may be taking us to the Kenway mansion.
Kenway? The pirate?
Master assassin and pirate, yes.
How much do you know about the Shroud of Eden?
It's said to heal the sick. Popular myth is that it brings people back from the dead, but the assassin records say that's not true. I've never heard of one being in London, though. Do you really think Edward Kenway could have found one?
He traveled extensively, so it's possible. But if he did, he kept it a closely guarded secret.
But if it's true, what a fire it would be.
Indeed. I'm eager to find out myself. It's surprising that you haven't already searched the Kenway house.
Edward's son, Haven, joined the Templars. When he died, the house passed on to Haven's sister.
And in all your time in London, you didn't go and have a look around? Weren't even a little curious.
Truly, I didn't expect to find anything there. We have no way of knowing how many times the buildings changed hands. I presumed Haven would have had it stripped bare before he left.
But if Miss Thorne thinks the shroud could still be there...
If there's a vault, the Templars haven't found it yet.
So the Templars owned a house with assassin treasures stored in it, and never located them.
We must be better at hiding things than they are.
I suppose patrolling is better than standing still.
I think this is it.
I think you're right. Look.
I'll be in the study. I don't want to be interrupted unless you have news of the lost notebook.
That makes getting in a challenge.
You still intend to enter?
If this is a Templar stronghold, it won't get any easier. Don't worry. We'll stay well away from Miss Lucy. Shall we? Can you check over there?
Of course.
I suppose patrolling is better than standing still.
Another assassin artifact. Something from Edward Kenway's time.
There's something fishy around here. Let's go!
This should belong to the assassins. I can't believe they've kept all of this. Miss Thorne is quite the collector. That looks interesting.
Still nothing here, same as last time. What was that?
I wish Father could have seen this.
What are we looking for?
I'm not quite sure.
What are the Templars not seeing?
Something only we can.
This piano is beautiful.
Do you play?
No. I wish I could. I love the sound. You?
A little. Enough to pass as a genteel young lady if I need to.
I would love to hear you play if the opportunity presents itself. Edward Kenway was a pirate. Where would a pirate hide his treasure?
I'd hide mine in a library.
Mine would be the library.
What are you doing?
Did you hear that?
Bye.
hell is it?
Clearly, Kenway had a strong sense of spectacle.
I wish we could take these with us.
History of the London assassins. Vault holes, vaults, a hidden key. This is it.
You say you heard music. There was no opening there before.
It's closing!
Yes, I can see that. Help me block it!
We need to find another way out.
An entire vault, filled with assassin history, left behind once again.
We'll just have to reclaim this one later, or find a better cache.
We? I thought you preferred to stay out of fieldwork.
I was thinking more of you and your brother. I shall provide planning assistance from the train.
Jacob's off marauding. There is a vacancy. Should you desire to broaden your horizons?
Oh, well, Evie, I... Oh, well, Evie, I will think on it.
You do that. Come, let's get above ground.
Mr. Frye, I trust that you had a productive meeting with Mr. Owen.
Oh, yes. We had the most wonderful chat. I found out the man behind Starek's soothing syrup is John Elliotson.
Dr. Elliotson? I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism. It ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Oh, and Mr. Frye, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
Where would I find the doctor?
As you've just witnessed, the application of too much pressure can sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined the organ. Send up a cadaver.
At once, Dr. Linson.
I don't care about your ethics, and I care even less about your damn patients. Now hand over your keys.
What are you doing?
Haven't you heard? You're fired. Now bugger off.
How to do it. What's the matter?
Oh, young man, help. I must speak with Miss Nightingale at once. One of the brutes stole my key, and there's no one around. I can't get out of here.
Stole your key? Don't go anywhere. I might be able to do something.
Oh, quite. Thank you, sir. Well, you'll know where to find me, sir. Oh, go on now, sir. I will wait here.
Thank you.
be wise to keep quiet. Not a peep from you.
I wonder why so few patients die this week.
Experimentations. I must speak to Nurse Nightingale. She will know what to do. His experimentations are making our patients worse. I am sure of it. There is something very peculiar about that Dr. Elliotson. You have my gratitude, sir. I shall inform Miss Nightingale that I'll not be working for this asylum ever again.
A little syrup won't cure. Haven't you heard? Stocks are low.
It will only take a moment. Ugh, bloody rats! Take that, you filth! Oh.
Murder! Help!
I'm sorry, sir, but you aren't allowed in here. I'm afraid I must ask you to leave, sir. Authorized personnel only. Please, go away. How hard can it be to fix a bloody crack in the wall? And don't come back! Ugh! Thank you.
Here it is, Doctor.
We will continue our experiment shortly. In a moment, we will compare the brains of our two specimens. Since both specimens had a propensity towards violent behavior, we should see similar protrusions in specific parts of their brains. Corpses do not have boots. At last it ends. Yet I can only think of beginnings. A better tomorrow. Forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
Do you truly believe murdering an old man will stop humanity's great architect? Crawford's Steric has a glorious design for mankind.
Designs are meant to be broken.
You're a child. A child who believes it can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade. Have you ever pondered the consequences of your actions, Jacob Frye? Or did your father teach you nothing?
Reason to end your life. Silence, and I might let you live. We're fast friends now, aren't we?
Elliotson expired, and soothing syrup production has ceased? Outrageous!
Frye intends to endanger all of London at the hands of the mob.
Or perhaps it doesn't intend much of anything at all.
Thank you.
Simply content to dice with our lives.
The asylum is shut up. Medical care throughout the city is in disarray. He does not, cannot understand the consequences of his actions. The man is clearly an anarchist.
Gentlemen. This tea was brought to me from India. By a ship. Then up from the harbor to a factory, where it was packaged and ferried by carriage to my door. Unpacked in the larder and brought upstairs to me. All by men and women who work for me. Who are indebted to me, Crawford Starrick. For their jobs, the time, the very lives they lead. They will work in my factories, and so too shall their children. And you come to me with talk of this Jacob Frye. This insignificant blemish who calls himself assassin? You disrespect the very city that works day and night so that we may drink this. This miracle, this tea.
I'm nearing the end of my research. Our beloved London shall not suffer such a bothersome fool for much longer.
And what of the sister I've heard of? Miss Frye.
Miss Frye shall be gutted. Soon enough. Delicious.